A high school teacher told his students that Pink Floyd did not make the wall to show us something we don't understand, but rather to show us how unwilling people are to learn about other cultures. At the time, Andy had a deep impression of the teacher's words. So when he embarked on his journey to make this project, he was thinking, how can we make music that shows people how to directly engage cultures in the most exciting and wild way possible? He thinks it is something we should call transethnic art, because we have to go into the other cultures, embody what we feel and see, and then make art based on it that would therein encourage others to do the same. Along this journey to make transethnic music and open a new artistic space between nations, he traveled the Silk Road from east to west, and Asia from north to south. He visited places such as Japan, the islands of Okinawa, the cities of China such as Beijing, Inner Mongolia, the center of Asia in Tuba, and across the lands of Xinjiang. These journeys have been scattered across a 10-year period, some short stays in places and some long ones, in order to write songs that embrace the idea of transethnic art. He learned different languages such as Japanese, Chinese, and Uyghur. He learned to sing the Kargura, a type of Tuvan throat singing. He learned instruments such as Tuvan fiddles. Throughout, he ventured to understand the inner workings of their cultures. During this entire process, he has been searching for musicians that have shared feelings about how to make transethnic art effectively. People that felt it was best done by first doing in-depth learning. He started to find people with similar ideas, and now they are discussing, rehearsing, and working to create a recording philosophy.
Hey! Mama-chan?
Hey!
Okay. Hey! Yes, it says.
This is a good place.
Yeah?
那是13年还是12年呢? 就是有一次...
12年那个
No Rose Jam 就当时 就是Andy 就来埃杰克嘛然后我就想这一个老外怎么能来埃杰克呢你能像一个字一个单词Radik呢Radik呢不是数字那么去发展的吗
Hanja，Hanja，Knife，Big Knife，Knife。Okay，Yes，Let's try to make the knife。我们就用吉他，尽量叫这个，就是这个东西，这个感觉，就这个声音。哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒哒。
我们尽量用出版的硬件，它特别像用出版硬件。象征一个，可能，就是一个战士拿那个剑，他肯定相信他的剑。然后我去年就唱完《古鲁塞德汗》以后，安迪突然找我了。 然后他说他在美国，他回国以后找我，然后他回来以后，就是我们碰了很多次面，然后就是他也说了自己的想法，然后 Radik 来了以后，我们聊了聊，然后去录音棚，就当时他就是，就我当时录这首歌的时候，我都不知道。 我们要录什么？ 我们是直接去录音棚，他就想要那种自然的那感觉。
Andy and Tuva, he introducing this project for how long he working for this project and what he want do it with this music together with some other musicians around the world. Some songs we already recording before, and then later he asked me, maybe I'm doing something here, and I'm listen careful some songs about some few them. So then I just put it inside my thing, my music, and my mind for this song. So then we have some communication with that, but. It is not problem because when we play together, is it, you know, music is not don't have language. Music is just music, and then I understand what he want to do and put it some new thing for his mind. And he said yes, good. And then we have discussing how's made it more best, more beautiful of something songs.
Infinity. All of you your meaning, your mind.
Yeah.
Your all of emotion, all of you, going with the stardust to the cosmos.
How Stuart culture put it, different from just not like just Tuvan throat singing or just igil or something, Tuvan traditional instruments. It's just more philosophy and more deeply beautiful for many years, for centuries. So I just introduce my own culture and introduce all Turkic world in this project. It's not like strong traditional before, but it's a little bit have different than, because people change, the human beings change too. So in the future, I think Tuvan music have, of course, need a strong tradition first, and then, of course, we need keep everything inside of us, inside of books, CDs, recording. So we need keep, because we need give it for the our children, for generations, for understanding what's the strong culture, what is it traditional way. So then, of course, sometimes we have experience in other cultures, like in this project too. So I've enjoyed play here.
All the lyrics in forest is very good.
Fairy tale. This song. Very interesting because it looks like a fairy tale. In Tuva we have many fairy tales, many stories about the animals, about the human being. So here I just have a rhythm, I have just have melody from the storytellers and just put it on these words from Indy, and some have, of course, some editing something, because we understand. Is it look like fairy tales? Is it look like traditional? But then if you listen carefully, if you understand, is it modern style? Because we put it rap also, raps and hip hop for this music, because it's interesting. This is why I understand in the inviting of the rap singer from Tuva, and he's singing very rightly, he understands everything here.
我第一次听，因为给我的印象很大。我大概听了一遍两遍以后，让我自己按照这个曲子来自己发挥。有些曲子确实不一样，因为我是长大的地方都是我们自己民族的，完了以后我偶尔也参加过，就是那个电子音乐或者摇滚音乐什么。这种呢确实，每个人什么人都听，我觉得特别喜欢的，大家都能接受的，然后旋律也挺好，很有想法的一个曲子，我挺喜欢这个曲子。 完了，我知道这曲子的故事以后，就是那个 北京的怎么怎么想法来写的那个东西。
Bu yarım keçide MSC çeksiz. Biz oturgan kulvak üzermeyim.
Meyim şimaldan.
Meyim şimaldan. Zerye egizde bulutlar peste. Kulvakımız çükmez.
Şimisi derya egizde bulutlar peste.
Cegiş şimdi şu an. Biyu şimba. Biyu. Biyu. Metafor.
你的希望高啊现实在下边对对对或者你可以go up你可以往上走你自己写的吗差不多对我跟一个朋友也写了很有想法这个我今天拉的就是我认为是我本身的我喜欢的就是我们就维吾尔族的
我从小学开始学的那个东西，其中维吾尔族的那个音乐的元素都有，不是都有，就是基本上我会拉的就都有了。音乐目标还有家人什么的，不会期待他们100%投入自己到这个项目上，但是呢，一步一步来，我觉得。
有办法找到一些共通点，然后通过这些共通点，慢慢发展，建设一个很好的协作关系。我们这样吧，那个麻烦帮我那个先弹拨儿，mute一下，我听一下那个底下的和弦，完了以后按照那个和弦来变一变。 如果更熟的话，我相信比这个还更好。嗯。可是现在因为他也忙，就是我这边也是，我们是好几天前我们约好了今天有录音，然后所以今天我们就直接来听了一遍，然后再录音了。一边听有一点也有像，就是微博说的，有些地方还有不一样。 因为这世界的就是，比如说 funk 那个东西，就是节奏啊，就节奏型，然后各个其他的旋律部分那些地方都，也有，所以我刚才说的是，这曲子里边很多很多东西就融合到一个曲子里边了，就是我们维吾尔族听的话，哎，就除了我以为我可能相信就是其他维吾尔族听的话，哎，有点像就维吾尔族的歌曲啊，然后就。
可能就别的民族的听的话，哎，有点像就是那个什么，很接近我们的什么歌曲，就反正大家都有的有些那个东西。两个都是新的东西，新的。第一首歌是有这个，这首歌是那个 lyrics， 你可以看一下，然后一边放，在这边我用那个。安迪是一个美国人嘛，他做一个。
新疆的歌曲，他还有，是用新疆语言来唱那个新疆歌曲，我觉得这个是很不容易的，而且这个这些歌儿，都有新疆味道，都有新疆味道。那个他一听他那个歌声，就能听出来有新疆味道。然后呢，加我的那个弹拨儿，还有那个阿迪丽的那个萨塔尔和是那个艾杰克以后。 那个歌在这边还是他的歌，他创作的他自己创作的他们他的歌，他的歌呢还是像新疆的歌，还是像新疆维吾尔族的歌，然后再加了我们的这个三个乐器以后更丰富，那个味道在那个里边出来，他的歌在这个里边出来，那相当美丽，我觉得挺好的。
Daddy-o
<音>这个东西我是不用看谱子，我是直接加不就完了吗？不用看谱子，这么简单吗？这个。
简单的
我现在在想，可能在这个地方。我也可以去掉那个吉他 solo， 那个是模仿 timbre。
哎，不要看胡子这个，没问题。一会儿热，一会儿热。你到时候把那个吉他也一块给我唱，录音的时候。
我没什么感觉，就是听了他的那个节奏以后，我就听他的那个调以后，我就是按照我自己的感觉，按照我的自己的即兴，就不要出去他的旋律，我也没听到他的旋律什么，我也没怎么听到是有什么旋律在那里面，也许可能他做好了以后可能有旋律吧，我光听到那个节奏，然后按照那个听了节奏以后，是这个调，这个应该是用这个弹。我就按照那个弹下来了。他就给我说即兴，给我你自己听一下，即兴给我演奏一下，把那个味道弄出来就行了。
是第二个怪，是吧？
我觉得它融合的有点像人聊天的样子，就是说偶尔会非常团结起来，偶尔会不太同意。偶尔会，虽然不太同意或者不太有和谐的感觉，但是反过来还是很好听。
Gasoline 是吧 ？Benzene， 好的。
然后后面的话就是还有那个最强的时候，可以加一下这通通。我可以试一下到那个小白那里，你就告诉小白把那个通通加一下，就准备好就 OK。
他调价，这样可以让他的那个很扩大的空间出来，因为你是玩一个东西，他是玩另一个东西。
啊，没问题。我就先去加那个捣乱的那个，
对。好，再来。
啊。
整体一个框架，但是似乎还是没有让他们很明白。因为这个涉及到相对多的民族，所以可能没有其他的，可能就是因为那个内容稍微多一点，所以只有一个办法让他们很好把握，就是做一个巡回，比如去欧洲，他们每天吃饭，每天互相交流，然后达到一个共同的理解，然后通过这些交流，可能我也会发现我怎么理解说了自己在做的东西。
Can it love?